One Night Only, zo gaat dat dan als je een artiest bent en je bent klaar om je nieuwe cd te releasen. Gisteravond waren ze hier en vanochtend zijn ze nog en vanavond zijn ze weer weg. Harry Charles en Jack, oftewel White Lies, guys, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for being here this early again.
Thank you very much for having us.
Yeah, of course, of course. Well, it's a great morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful day.
We say in Dutch, with your nose in the butter.
Yeah.
Because we've got some great food.
Oh yeah?
And I didn't try it myself. In de studio hebben wij Lambert van der Veer. Lambert, goedemorgen.
Goedemorgen.
Jij bent bakkerszoon. Je bent gewoon bakker. Maar ik zeg maar naam even dat je bakkerszoon bent, omdat jouw pa heeft iets bedacht.
Dat klopt.
Leg maar uit.
De Gelderse Verleiding uit Barneveld.
Ja, de Gelderse Verleiding. Maar zo noemen ze toch ook de omgeving Barneveld?
Dat klopt.
Ja. Maar wat is het?
Het is een broodje van rozijnen, suikernips en Zwitserse room. Dat is een gele room met slagroom. En afgewerkt met kaneelsuiker.
Oké, het ziet er vooral het ziet er zoet uit.
Het is een overheerlijk product. We verkopen er duizenden
per week. Is het een beetje een bagelachtig iets, of niet? Nee. Het is meer een soort krentenbolletje.
Het is meer een soort krentenbol-idee, inderdaad.
Duizenden per week, zeg
ja,
je?
Dat,
maar gewoon in heel het land? Nee, dat kan
niet. Nee, alleen in de gemeente Barneveld.
Ja, precies. Dan ben je in Barneveld.
Maar het is wel landelijk, want echte bakkers, zeg maar, die hebben ook het recept van de Gelderse Verleiding. En daar,
heeft je pa dat gewoon verpatst?
Die heeft het verpatst, inderdaad. Alleen de echte bakkers, hè?
Oké, duidelijk. Ik ben heel benieuwd. Guys, if you would like to try, I don't know. It looks a bit sweet.
Hold on.
What's the filling?
Waarom is het Zwitserse room eigenlijk? Cream van Swiss.
Het is Zwitserse room omdat het smeuig is.
Wow.
En het is met slagroom en gele room, zeg maar, dan maakt het wat aantrekkelijker dan alleen gele room.
En de Gelderse Verleiding. Dit is called de Gelderse Verleiding.
It's very nice. Very nice. It's very rich.
You got it all in your beard, Charles.
Oh my god. What a nightmare.
Het is juli, de maand van Gelderland. Jij hebt ook nog wat dranken meegenomen.
Ja,
of we dat nou echt moeten doen op de vroege ochtend?
Dit Barnevelse spraakwater.
Is het echt ik ken natuurlijk spraakwater alleen van Extins. Spraakwater lest de dorst. Maar wat is dit dan?
Het is een echt Barnevelse drankje. Zeg maar een soort snaps, zeggen wij dan.
Oh ja. You guys know snaps? Yeah, that's
what okay. Oh, come on.
Okay.
What time is it?
Okay.
We've already had three.
You already had three?
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to this one. Cheers, guys. The Barnevelse spraakwater.
Jesus Christ.
So.
I'm impressed. Yeah. 8 a.m. Yeah. Wow.
So.
Just trying to catch your breath.
Nice. Met dank aan de slijterij uit Barneveld ook, moet ik even zeggen.
Ergens.
Nee, je hebt dat eventjes geregeld. Maar jij drinkt het ook gewoon.
Ik drink het ook gewoon mee.
Ik was op zoek naar typische Gelderse gerechten. Als jij er nog eentje hebt, kom maar door. Mail met Beel. Giel@3fm.nl. Ik begin nog gelijk een beetje vaag te lullen. Mail met Beel, waar slaat dat op? Mede met Belen.
Ja.
So guys, let's talk about music.
Now we're nice and lubricated.
Yeah.
I don't think I've drunk this early since Reading Festival when we were 15.
Oh yeah. Do you guys have to play at Reading this year?
We are, actually.
Yeah, very excited about it.
Voor de mensen die het niet kennen, echt een groot festival is dat. Dat is, in Nederland zou je het kunnen vergelijken met Pinkpop. Het is daar natuurlijk een stuk groter, maar het is wel gewoon een beetje, daar waar je wil staan. Ja, Big TV, een nieuwe CD is coming.
Yes.
Was it a struggle? Was it fun?
It was really good fun, but we spent a year making it.
Yeah.
So I suppose there was some struggling involved as well.
Of course, but that's music.
I think we really genuinely enjoyed the whole process. You know, so I can't wait for people to hear it.
I've got
to
hear a piece of the title track. this the first track and the title track?
It's I think it's just it opens the record, and I think it's just really it's a really good cross section of the lyrical themes and the musical themes on the album. So it just made sense to to name the album after it.
Dan weet je gelijk een beetje van nou ja, als je date opzet, dit is een beetje de sound van het album. BTV, okay. Let's talk about other songs. For example, Goldmine. Can you take us back to the moment, you guys?
I can definitely take you back to the moment of Goldmine, because it was the last day in the studio after a year of making a record, and we had about 4 hours to go, and we didn't have a song.
Oh, we needed a song.
We had 9 songs recorded.
Oh, I think we
were trying to argue and say, but can't it just be a 9-track album? And someone had a phone call with the record label, and they said, no, it can't. No. Write a song now.
Turns out we're contractually obliged to write 10 songs for our record. So.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a quickie.
We listened to some Placebo through the big speakers and went, okay, we can do this.
Is this a true story?
Yes, it's a true story.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is the result. It's good that you told this story, because
every time I hear it, it always sounds better than I remember. Yeah. It's like, this actually is quite good, this song, for 4 hours work.
It's just a great White Lies track, and I'm thinking, oh, it's so easy for the guys. Why did it take so long? Fuck, that's great. Okay.
Well, some of the songs took about 6 months to write, so it's okay to have one that was easy.
Okay. Well, Getting Even, for example. What was
that took a really long time.
Yeah,
a really long time, because Harry and I worked out the sort of basic parts of it at his house, and we brought it round, and Ed Buller, the producer, was really overexcited about the chorus. But yeah, we had a really hard time getting the rhythm section sorted for that one, because nothing seemed to work, and none of the bass lines or drum beats seemed to like push it forward enough. And I think at one point Harry and Ed went to go and make coffee or something, and Jack and I just sat there and then managed to figure it out, and now it sounds great. We're having a lot of fun playing it live as well.
Deze maand komt hij uit. Big TV. So everything is finished?
Yes, everything is ready.
The thank you's already written?
Yes.
Yeah.
We're not big on thank yous, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, we just usually write thank you to everyone who helps.
Yeah. What a bummer is that. Okay, Harry, who do you have to thank for this CD?
Well, I'd like to thank these guys for making it with me.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
For realizing my dream.
You're welcome. I know my check's in the mail.
I guess we should thank our manager. He's out here. He's out just outside the room.
Okay.
Day-to-day PA.
But you know, you've always got to thank someone who's willing to get up at 7 a.m. with you and come to a radio station.
Nathan, could you just get me another coffee? Anytime.
Manager, what do you make your best? I was wondering, because Jack and Charles, you guys, you know each other since you were in diapers or something.
Yeah.
Do you have
still in diapers?
Yeah. Do you have nickname for each other?
We actually don't. We're not so good with nicknames, and
we have loads of nicknames for lots of other people that we can't share on the radio because they're too horrendously rude. But
we call Harry, like, often gets shortened to H, and then H gets shortened to H, well, not extended actually, to H-bomb.
H-bomb.
But we have this thing. There's this thing that goes along amongst like touring crew. Touring crew all have really stupid nicknames.
Yeah.
Like, there'll be a guy called like Johnny the Hat, and you'll say, why is he called Johnny the Hat? And someone will say, oh, because he never wears a hat. And so we have this name for Harry, which I can't explain all of the chain, but we call Harry Woolly, and somehow Woolly goes back to the fact that he's allergic to nuts and doesn't like fruit, but we'll have to save that
that's
for
really
another day.
Tentative link. Okay. They gave me a roadie name, basically.
Yeah, that's Harry's roadie name is Woolly.
Woolly, Woolly, Woolly. Woolly, Woolly. Okay, Woolly, can you take us back to the moment you wrote There Goes Our Love Again?
Well, this, yeah, this was in actually when we, so when we first started writing for the record, me and Charles went to a cottage in the countryside in the UK. Okay. Yeah, we had a bit of
romantic.
A bit of romantic loving time together.
Yeah. Well, I have to be, the latest news is since today there's a gay marriage in the UK.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, maybe one day.
Wow.
No, sorry.
I haven't proposed yet.
No, but you were there in the romantic place and then?
Yeah, and then I got down on one knee. No, and then...
then both knees.
Yeah, but it's one of like the very first songs we wrote for the record, actually. And it was, again, a struggle. Like, it went through so many different forms and so many different guys until we got it together. But it was at the birth of the record that we wrote that song. And I think it's good that it's the first single, because it's the first one of the first things we heard when we were writing the record, you know?
Wow, great.
Yeah.
It's also fun to see the clip. The video, because well, I don't know if I can still rent you guys for my wedding or something. It looks a bit like that, but that's fun, and that's really that's really a great way of thanking your fans. Is this weekend? No, next week. Next week, you guys gonna perform at Hoxton Square Bar in Kitchen,
yes,
London.
Indeed, yes.
And
yeah.
Well, you have to explain.
Okay, so it was 5 years ago. We were going to try and do it 5 years ago to the day, but the timing didn't work out. But it was 5 years ago that the White Lies played our first ever show, and we played it in this venue.
That was the first gig ever.
Yeah.
Yes.
And we had lots of our... On the first show, we had lots of our friends and family there, obviously, but also lots of record labels, and it was very, very stressful. Yeah. I remember actually being absolutely terrified. Mm. I think as soon as we walked off
and
stage...
And parents and family.
Yeah, off stage, we'd just forgotten everything, because it's just like a mind blank, you know. It's just like, it's so scary. But so this time... We can do it again and enjoy it, you know, and do it for our fans, and again for our friends and family. And it's a really nice way to introduce everyone to the album, I think. Yeah,
great. That's great.
Yeah.
Why don't you go to the playground?
Okay.
It's really a playground today, because if you guys looking there, you look a bit like children.
Yeah.
Je zit
we always look like children.
Ja, oké. Okay. Met een xylofoontje erbij. Echt heel tof. Ze zijn akoestisch dus. Ja, dit is vet uitgezocht hoor, die kleine kick. Maar ik moest eraan denken door die videoclip. Die hoort bij het nummer There Goes Our Love Again.